I'm sort of like a wild kid when I was young. I got chased out of the house. I'm so used to having this type of setback, this type of failure. And I started boxing at a very young age. And all this really built up my character. From the start, I never really planned to work for the money. My parents are all hawkers. And I was thinking that, okay, maybe I should follow their footstep. At least I will experience how they really feel.
For us as chefs, I think it's about feeding people. And it's the only thing that we can do.
Helping people that's less fortunate, I enjoy doing that. That's also the reason why, no second thoughts. When this thing comes, somebody needs to go, I volunteer myself.
You know that you're going to bring some smile to someone out there. You know, some memory that you're going to give to them. And I think that's why we did it.
Pre-COVID was really buzzing, was really busy, but this year is a loss. Everybody always say that youngsters can start again everything, but I throw all the apples in. It's depressing. It's very depressing when I go home, I will feel like my business is not sustaining itself.
I was very worried about the business, about the staff. It was a very worrying time.
So the only thing you could do was try to find solutions where you could help people around you.
Every individual human being deserves a pack of warm food and to make sure they are full. As you know, we run a lot of multiple brands. This time around, it's a project where no longer your brand, my brand, everybody coming in together, we work as one, which I think is really good. I think more of this kind of teamwork should actually come in, not only just during COVID.
Basically, the motivation that got me back up, right, is maybe ego and my wife. Hey, I really need to work hard. I need to think of something to at least make my wife proud. So I sort of start this foundation with my friends. Then we were like, hey, let's do something good. Just focus on giving people the right food and the right nutrition that they really need to get past these hard times. And who really finish and really enjoy the food, right, are the ones that really need the food, not the ones that really eat for pleasure. This food is not just like, oh, plain rice, plain vegetable, but this food is really cooked with heart, cooked with passion, and has so much flavor in it.
Especially in Singapore, where the migrant dormitories are really in need of help. So we researched a little bit on what their normal diet is. And we slowly tweaked the recipes so that we are able to feed them a balanced diet. And on that part, I think Chef Damien, he has come up with a lot of recipes that were familiar to them.
Where the medical staff can help with the patient, we can give them food. So that is how we actually started. We are also planning on special packaging just for all these medical staff, easier for them to eat. Food that sends right to their doorstep and the food is still hot after an hour. So these are all the plannings within this period of time where it's not easy.
During that time, it was really hard. And my wife was also complaining. She told me, right, you're always so busy, you don't even have time to call me. But when she ended with the line, right, but I'm proud of you for what you're doing. I love you. Then I was like, hey, my wife is proud of me, really. Finally, my wife is proud. I'm making my loved one proud. Like, it's really fulfilling because to me, I feel that if you stay stagnant in your life, right, you die.
The biggest challenge was cooking for 450 people. You can't just cook for 450 people and dump everything in the pot without any feel. You've got to do it systematically. You've got to do it with love. Why? Because these are people that really need food that comes from the heart. You should draw the inspiration from home. Like your mother, when she finds that you don't eat fish because of the bones, she'll remove the bones for you so that you eat it. Eventually, when we got word that the migrant workers were very happy with what we did, it makes us happy. That is something that you can't buy. That brought a sense of satisfaction to everyone that was involved in this community kitchen.
If you believe that we can make a difference, things will change. As a single mom myself, I need to set a role model for my son. At the same time, I need to be very, very positive, and I need to work very, very hard. What I'm doing today, my partner and my son will be very proud of me. And this experience, it will follow me for life.
People sometimes they text me saying that, hey, you are my motivation. You guys are doing the right things. You guys give me hope. And I'm glad that I'm able to give them this little hope that they don't give up just because of little setback in their own life. Honestly, all these kind of little setback, right, it makes you think a little more, make you work a little harder. That's why I need to make sure that I give as much as possible back to the society at this right moment.
It's been a very humbling experience. I mean, it's so humbling that it puts everybody on the same level. That makes you think that when you come out of this, you have so much more wisdom to appreciate the little things that you have in life.
There's a crisis of a generation. We are blessed that we are in a position to be able to bless other people. We have to take this opportunity and experience to learn to be resilient. So we need to adapt and change. And I believe that our generation will grow to be tougher people, tougher Singaporeans.